guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope you all had a wonderful holiday, and 2021 is coming to an end, so I figured why not share with you some of my most worn fragrances of 2021. And I love these type of videos. I love personally watching them because it gives me a really good idea of what fragrances people really truly enjoyed and what they wore the most. So I'm just gonna jump right in and leave a comment down below and let me know what fragrances you wore this year. I'd love to know, and because it gives me ideas to maybe some new fragrances to try. So yeah, I'm just gonna jump right into it. Okay, the first one here, it comes as no surprise because I've worn this for years and I still think it's such a classic in my collection. And this is by Prada and this is Infusion de Iris. This is a huge bottle too. I just love wearing this because it is so clean. It's such a clean, slightly soapy type of fragrance, and I find I wore this a lot, especially on days that I didn't feel that I wanted to wear a heavy fragrance. I have a lot of heavy fragrances in my collection. That's the type of scents I tend to pull for. You'll probably see in this video. But if I need to wear something that I don't want to really kind of offend anybody, or I don't want to, I'm not probably really shouldn't be wearing fragrance, I tend to wear this one because I think it's light enough. It's just smells super clean. Or if I get out of the shower and I just want to wear something nice and gentle and clean and fresh, I tend to wear this one and pull for this one. It's not the longest lasting fragrance that I own in my collection at all, but I just tend to really like the way it smells. For an everyday type of fragrance, non-offensive, super clean, easy, and fun, and classy too. So you can really dress this up or dress this down, which is so versatile. I love this one. So that is Prada, and this is Infusion de Iris, and this is just the original Eau de Parfum. Okay, this one here, I have gone through decants, samples, and I finally just bought a full bottle of it because I decided it was time. And this is by Mancera, and this is Roses Vanille. This is such a lovely fragrance. Now this bottle also too is a 4 fluid ounce bottle, so it is a really, really big bottle. And as you can see, I have worn a great deal of this one and it's really strong. It's very long lasting, so you really don't need a lot of it. But this one I just find so comforting. It's very sweet. It has like a really nice musk in the base, which I find at times can be quite clean. I like to wear this day or night or any time of year really. If I do tend to wear this in the summertime, I will go a little bit lighter on the sprays only because I don't overspray my fragrances really at all because I just don't like to. I don't like to feel suffocated. But this one here, you got to go kind of light on the sprays because it will get really strong and it will project all day. But yeah, I really liked this one. It's just a sweet, nice, rose, vanilla, musky scent. And again, another versatile scent. I've got a lot of compliments on this one when I've worn it and a lot of people seem to enjoy it. So that is Mancera Roses Vanille. Excellent one if you haven't tried it. It's really nice. This one here is one that after I bought it, I don't really own anything else from this line, but this one really struck my interest when I went to purchase it. As soon as it launched, I really wanted it. And this is by Kayali, and this is Invite Only Amber 23. I probably wore it, it's like down to here. I wore a lot of this one. I find when I'm looking for that spicy scent, but I don't want something super, like overly strong, powerful, this is long lasting on me, but I really find that this one is just the perfect amount of spice without being overly done. I can kind of get away with wearing this even when I don't want to offend anybody because it's like a softer, spicier, sweeter scent. And it does have a little bit of, it has like tobacco in here and I think it has tobacco, but it's just like a nice, spicy, sweet scent. Not offensive and not too hard to wear. So that is Kayali Invite Only Amber 23. This one here has been a favorite since I purchased it, and I really like, if I want to wear something a little bit more, it's very versatile. I find like a lot of the fragrances that I tend to want to pull for are more versatile, but this one is by Nishane, and this is 100 Silent Ways. If I'm looking for like this nice, sweet, kind of slightly floral vanilla, I tend to pull for this one. I have worn this one a lot this year. My husband really likes this one when I wear it. It's very long lasting. If I'm looking for something that I know will last, it's people pleasing, it won't offend anybody, and I enjoy the scent as well, I'll pull for this one. And I have Okay, this one here I really enjoy. I have had many samples of it in previous years. I've worn it for many years. I get decant samples, sprays, mini travel size, and I decided to buy a full bottle, and I still really love this one. And this one is by Replica, and this is Jazz Club. Now, this one to many, this one may come off masculine. It does have a masculine quality to it, but if you like scents that have a boozy quality or a little bit of some smokiness or even have a little bit masculine edge to them, you may really like this one. This one is, it has a little bit of like a tobacco vibe to it along with some booziness, and it has a sweetness, an underlying sweetness to it, which I feel like makes it more versatile and more unisex than too masculine. But like I said, this one, some people, if you're used to wearing more feminine, floral, light scents, it may not be for you, but yeah, if you like the type of scents that I like, you probably would really enjoy this. And I really like wearing it. I've worn it, I could wear this all year, especially like summer nights or spring nights, but I love to wear this in the fall and winter especially. And I've worn it a lot, especially this fall and winter. So that is a Replica Jazz Club. This one here, I've talked about countless times on my channel, so I won't go too crazy into detail. I'll try not to go too crazy into detail about any of them because I've talked about a lot of these, but this is by Alexandria Fragrances, and this is Lady Diana. And you can see I have almost used almost the whole bottle of it. This is a dupe or a replica of Parfums de Marly Delina. Delina is a fragrance that I wasn't sure if I wanted to buy the full bottle, the real bottle, because I wasn't sure if I would get sick of the smell. When I first tried it, I didn't really care for it, and then I bought this and I really enjoyed it. I especially enjoy it in the spring and summer. I find this to be quite a fresh rose, tart type of scent, and I really enjoy that. It just reminds me of like the spring and summer, because I think I wear that a lot during that time. It's quite a fresh scent to me that I really enjoy to wear. This is really long lasting as well. I think if I were to like repurchase this, I would still repurchase the Alexandria one, because I find that it gives me what I need and they're quite affordable. So yeah, that is Alexandria Lady Diana. And another kind of replica type of company or fragrances that I do quite wear often, and this is the Oil Perfumery, and that's the brand. This one in particular is called Intense Cafe. It's very similar to Mancera Roses Vanille, but I liked it. You can see I've worn quite a bit of it. For an oil, that's quite a bit. I like to wear this when I want to wear Roses Vanille, but I don't want to have the powerful strength of Roses Vanille. This one is still strong and powerful, but if I want to wear it, say like the gym or somewhere where I want a little bit of a lighter take on Roses Vanille, I'll pull for this one. So this one actually is quite similar to Roses Vanille. It just has a little bit, I think, of a coffee note, which is very slightly detectable. But yeah, if you're looking for a good brand to try, high-end brands that they kind of replicate or inspired by, I would try Oil Perfumery. Really nice, long-lasting too. This one, I was so excited when I ended up getting a full bottle of it, because I tried some samples and I just like fell in love with it, and I tried some inspired by fragrances, which I really loved, but I found a full bottle before they repackaged that, luckily, because the new packaging is really expensive. This is Guerlain and this is Angelique Noir. I really love this. This is a very nice green, slightly spicy vanilla. It is, to me, a more sophisticated vanilla. It's one of the more sophisticated ones in my collection, and I really enjoy the dry down. It dries down to a really nice, creamy vanilla, typical of Guerlain styling, but I really love the opening in this. It has Angelica, which is very green. It kind of has like a little bit of an herbaceous feel to it, and I love that about it. It's a very different take on vanilla, but as it dries down to a nice kind of creamy, powdery type of vanilla. Typical of Guerlain, but I really enjoy this one, and I have really enjoyed wearing it, and I'm kind of babying this bottle because to repurchase the newer one is very expensive. But so yeah, that is Guerlain and that is Angelique Noir. Excellent. This one here I wore a lot in the spring and summer when I first got it, and I still really enjoy it. If I want something that smells quite a little bit more floral but sweet, and it's a floral that I can handle, and that is Ralph Lauren, and this is Woman. This is the original Eau de Parfum. They do make an intense, which I do have and I do like, but for I really still enjoy this one. This one has just a very perfect amount of sweetness, floralness, and it does have a little bit of woodiness to it as well. And it's quite long lasting, and it's really like, it makes me feel put together. It makes me feel, it's like an everyday scent. It's not offensive. People seem to like this one, and I really like that in the spring and summer because it just smells, it kind of smells fresh too to me. You know, it does remind me a little bit of the color gold for some reason when I smell it. It has this kind of richness to it, and yeah, so I really, really like this one, and that is Ralph Lauren Woman. I have two left here. This one here, I have been obsessed with it ever since I purchased it, and I still love it, and I have worn it a lot since I purchased it, and this is by Montale, and this is Honey Oud. If you like a spicy, sweet type of incense-y, strong scents, this one is really, really, really amazing. It is strong, it is spicy, it is sweet, it is projecting, it's kind of loud, but I just love that. I do like 1 to 2 sprays of this and it lasts me all day, and it projects and the sillage is amazing. It may not be for everyone. I think some people say this a little bit masculine on them. Like I said, the type of fragrances that I go for can lean a little bit on the masculine side, I guess. Like this to me, I find super feminine, like, you know, to the max. This one's very feminine to me. This is not that. This is a little bit more, this is woodier, this is spicier, this is a little bit incense-y, it's smoky, it's sweet from the honey, but this is like ideal and perfect for me. So yeah, this is Montale Honey Aoud. It's amazing. If you haven't tried it, I would at least try it. If you can get a sample. Last one here is another one. I love this scent and I pick this up all the time. And this is Carolina Herrera Sandal Ruby. I love this. This one is the perfect amount of spice, sweetness. It has some floral notes to it. I think there's tuberose in here. There's definitely, I think there's maybe even saffron, there's sandalwood. So it has this like, it's a woody, sweet, spicy, floral scent. It's quite sophisticated. It's strong. I just think this is so, it has like a red bottle, and for some reason it reminds me of like a red high heel shoe, which I never wear high heels, but I don't know. This one is just like, if you're going out on like a date or, you know, want to just smell really, I don't know, different maybe. This one's a beautiful one. Carolina Herrera Sandal Ruby, and the bottles are stunning. Guys, I totally forgot to mention that I also have been obsessed in wearing Initio's Atomic Rose. This one is amazing. I have gone through decants, samples, and inspired fragrances. This one here, I have been wearing nonstop. I pretty much wear this almost every single day. I usually have to try to tell myself, oh, put it down, you gotta wear something else. But this one right here is amazing. It's long lasting. It's a compliment getter. Love this one. So that is Initio Atomic Rose. So yeah, guys, those are the fragrances that I wore mostly in 2021. I love all of these, and I continue to wear them and pick these up out of everything that I have. So let me know down below what fragrances you wore mostly this year. I'd love to know them, and I hope you guys have a great holiday and happy new year, and I will see you later. Bye, guys.